Hi, I'm Ben.
And I'm John.
And together we're OCB.
Reactions.
And today we got another request. Well, we're getting to another request from Melon Johnson. I'm sorry it takes so long. We're trying to get to everybody. This is a secondary request from Coheed and Cambria song that...
I'm pretty sure it's actually Coheed and Cambria, dude.
Oh, yeah. I was just looking at the singer. Never mind. So it's Coheed and Cambria. This is Welcome Home. He had us do The Suffering, but we lost that one. We had some technical glitches. Right. So we thought, like, rather than faking it, we'll just go to the next song and say, like, oh, well, we didn't dislike the song.
Right.
It was a fun little rock song, and I enjoyed it. I mean, Coheed and Cambria is a good band.
Yeah.
I think they're highly overrated, and their fans are a little too fanatical about them.
Yes.
But, if you like them, you like them. More power to you. I'm not going to tell you not to like what is essentially a really good band.
Right. Just not our cup of tea.
Yeah, it's not on my favorites list. Nowhere near it. But this is Coheed and Cambria, Welcome Home. So we're going to check this one out and give an honest reaction to it as opposed to, like, faking the other song.
Right. And before we go on, please like, subscribe, hit the notification, and share. Get the word out about the show.
Okay. And this is Coheed and Cambria, so this should be about dinosaurs. The Cambrian period. Actually like this little intro better than the other one.
Okay, I'm actually digging this.
Well, crap. I've heard this song before.
I have not.
This is the first song by them I ever heard, AC. And right there is why they're not on my list.
Yes.
Good. That's Cambria, Cambria, Cambria.
Are you sure? I think Hagrid has a band now.
Oh, yeah. So Buckbeak, Beak, or whatever.
Yeah, Buckbeak must have bit his nuts off.
Yeah. I mean, I like this song.
I can dig everything but the vocals.
I mean, hearing his Geddy Lee sounding ass. Just makes you say, like, oh, they're a Rush ripoff band, and now it's not as good.
Right.
But they're not.
No, musically, totally different. Just,
I mean, they don't have anywhere near as good a drummer.
No. it's kind of difficult to be better than Milford.
The best in the world.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, his voice isn't bad. It even fits the music.
I don't know. I can't dig it. You know how I am with my high-pitched vocals, right?
See, I'm a huge King Diamond fan, so it's like, it doesn't bother me that much.
That's the only reason why I don't, and yes, I know there are metalheads out there that are probably going to want to crucify me for saying this, but it's why I can never get into Led Zeppelin. I just could not stand Plant Force.
I don't know if I call him metalhead. I mean, that was heavy metal was a tongue-in-cheek insult to Led Zeppelin because of their name, which was them taking up an insult for their name.
Right.
No, I like this song. I mean, I like this the first time. I mean, I understand why people really get into it, too. They're a really solid band.
Well, they are very tight. And good musicians.
I mean, and they go all over the place.
Yeah.
I mean, I like this song and then the...
Okay, and throwing in guitar solo, I mean...
I think one of the reasons it took me a while become a huge Coheed and Cambria fan was it's like, I really like this song, and then the next song goes, I really like it. It's like, but I want to hear that for more of that, which I appreciated it. It's like, oh, well, we're doing this now. And then we'll come back and do this. You know? Like how David Bowie did.
Right.
Also, I wouldn't put him up first. If David Bowie finds this band, they'd been more, it would have been better.
Well, David Bowie in front of a lot of bands, they'd be better.
That little background choral thing just adds to the epicness of it. Yeah, we didn't stop the song, we talked through it, but
yeah,
that's because I didn't want to stop it. I was got really into it. But.
I do feel kind of bad now that, you know, I never got into Coheed and Cambria other than the vocals. No matter what, it'll just be like nails on a chalkboard to me.
Which you can't avoid. I mean, you can't get around that. If some aspect of a band just takes you out of it,
right?
You can't avoid that. I mean, he doesn't bother me that much, so I'm used to the higher pitch guy vocals, although it kind of upsets me. I want you to, if you're a dude, I want you to stand and walk like John Wayne. I don't.
the only band that I ever got into and enjoy with vocals like that was Rush themselves. But I think that his vocals actually meshed perfectly with them.
That could be, I mean, I don't think it's terrible for that, but I could also see where that limits what they can and can't do.
Right.
On a certain level. I mean, he's on key. He has range.
Yes.
He's just kind of being a boy choir kind of sounding guy. He sounds like a big hairy eunuch. But it's not that he has a good voice. It's just not. It's like, it does take me out a little bit. Because he comes in, it's like all of a sudden it's not as epic as the music had set up.
But that's another one from M. Allen Johnson.
I liked it.
Keep them coming, man.
I appreciated it. It's like it was and I knew they were a good band coming into it. And the other song, I like this song way better than
yes,
the other song.
Yes, I do like this song better.
Although this video didn't have centaurs in it, and centaurs are cool. Although
and
it might
mermaids.
Be the, and mermaids and krakens and
yeah.
The various things that probably ripped his testicles off. Okay, I'm going to stop pounding on that because that's just he has a high-pitched voice. I'm sure yeah. he has a hairy set down there. It's whatever. And he probably uses it way more than I do. So, you and big being a big hairy Chewbacca-looking man, he is a rock star.
Yes. But no... I still give it a good review, even
Same
though
here.
I don't like, even though I don't dig the vocals that much. Musically, it's amazing.
Yeah.
So, and before we finish out here, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share.
Yep. And so, fare thee well.
Thank you.